In the last video, I talked about the blinding blue light that comes from the laser engraver when we're making nanoparticles. Now it's a big problem for our eyes. Well, I've come up with a solution for it. The solution was quite simple when I thought about it, and it was to cover the petri dish. So what I did was I 3D printed a top for my petri dish. Now when I make my nanoparticles, or when we make nanoparticles with the laser, we will fill the petri dish. This is a 100 millimeter petri dish. We will fill this up with 50 milliliters of fluid, put our sample in here, and then run the laser on it. Now I like to put the top on the petri dish. It doesn't impede the progress at all. And what it does do, keeps the water from evaporating too quickly. Because the laser has a fan on it, blows down into here, and it tends to evaporate the water very fast. And distilled water, well, you know, it takes time to make distilled water, and to keep adding it, the petri dish cover keeps it all enclosed. It also helps us with the laser, too, to a certain extent. And I'll talk about that in a minute. And what you do is, you take the petri dish cover, and you put it in here like this. It has a little hole on the top, and the little hole is to allow the laser to go through. Now, it's not a very big hole because we're trying to keep that blue laser light from escaping. But I have found that you don't really need to move the laser very much. A 10 millimeter square over your sample is going to be fine for creating nanoparticles. You don't need to cover the whole entire sample. So the small hole helps us. Then you're just going to take your top and you're going to put it down like this, and there you go. Now the other thing that is nice about this and covering the sample with the petri dish cover wasn't a problem with the 5-watt laser, because the 5-watt laser, the laser is hard connected to the top of this thing. But on the 18-watt laser, there's these two little tiny thumb screws that hold the laser up and down at the proper height. Now, if you don't tighten those screws enough, if your petri dish is open and you got liquid in it, it'll just jam into that liquid. That ain't going to be too good for the laser, I don't think. Or your sample, for that matter. Could screw up the laser head. But with the petri dish cover on, and or this hard plastic cover on top, the laser just would harmlessly hit this plastic cover, and it would just continue going back and forth like this. It might scratch this a little bit, or the petri dish cover, but at least you won't be wrecking the laser by immersing it in water. Now, if you didn't want to print the 3D cover, what can you do? Very simply, all you really have to do is cover this dish with duct tape, preferably black duct tape, to prevent the laser light from escaping. Just cover the top, cover the sides, and you're set right then and there. I put my petri dish on a black slate bottom, so I don't need to do anything about the bottom. And you don't want to tape the bottom, because what will happen is if you do miss the target and you tape the bottom of the petri dish, you will wind up laser engraving the backside of this petri dish. Now, the other thing I want to talk about is something people have said to me, well, especially with having to prop this up on a 2 to 4 degree angle and to keep the laser from bouncing directly back into the laser head unit. How do we keep the sample from falling, from rolling, from sliding down? Let's face it, when we put water in the petri dish and we start the whole thing going and you got little vibrations from the machine moving back and forth, this sample tends to move. And I will be the first to say that it does tend to move. You've seen in the previous laser video, on the laser, the piece of slate that I actually burned and melted the slate with, because, well, the sample slid out and the laser just did burn the slate. So what can we do? So I've devised a way, and that's with these small neodyme super magnets. I put one of these small things, four of them underneath on the bottom like this, and stacked two or three on top inside the dish, and you can move them around just by sliding your thumb under the bottom and move these things around to surround your sample that will hold it in place very nicely. The neodyme magnets are coated probably with stainless steel, so I don't think it's a problem as far as contaminating the sample at all. I'm Tom, Alchemy Wizard, and don't forget, when using lasers, eye protection. It also makes you look cool.